good afternoon, everyone. So yes, I am a Pittsburgh resident, living in the South Hills of Pittsburgh. No offense to St. John's. actually, did go to law school at Duquesne many, many years ago. And again, at Pitt. And actually, my father, I was thinking about this before. My father is actually a Duquesne alumni as well. He was a pharmacist. He came over from Italy probably 60 years ago and became a pharmacist and actually worked for Thrift Drug for 35 years. So he was behind the counter. So there's a deep legacy of pharmacy within our family, and obviously a legacy within Duquesne as well. So I welcome everyone from Duquesne, both law school, pharmacy, to St. John's students from pharmacy, and look forward to maybe trying to talk a little bit about specialty pharmacy and the way we perceive it, you know, within our organization, as well as how I've kind of worked within specialty pharmacy over the last decade or so. So with that, let's talk a little bit about the evolving market of specialty drugs. So when you think about it, this pipeline is exploding. 50% of the top 100 drugs, eight of the top 10 will be specialty pharmaceuticals by last year, 2016. That did in fact come to fruition in terms of that. You'll see another slide coming up soon that I'll show you just how the growth trend has been within the specialty drug area. The pipeline is exploding. There are probably 700 to 800 molecules being reviewed right now within oncology alone. There's a lot of activity within orphan and ultra-orphan disease states as well, in which, you know, we at Cardinal Health Specialty Pharmacy actually work with a product that we service literally 10 patients in the entire United States. But a manufacturer did come up, you know, with a product to service that particular very ultra-orphan disease state. So it kind of gives you a little bit of the capacity and the feel for exactly what's happening within specialty pharmacy. This is the slide that I was referring to. As you can see, back in 2012, the breakout between the percentage of products that we consider quote-unquote specialty versus what are considered traditional was 70-30, give or take. And you could see a steady incline where in 2018, you know, we are predicting probably about a 50-50 split. Most of the innovation in pharmacy is happening at some sort of specialty level at this point in time. It's usually a targeted therapy. There's usually a particular patient population that the therapy is targeted to. There are quite a few different programs associated with the management of that patient. Oftentimes, the FDA will, as a condition to bring it to the market, will impose what's called a risk evaluation mitigation strategy on a particular product. And one of the core functions of specialty pharmacy, and Royce will talk about this a little bit more, is really around handling that REMS process and managing that patient and making sure that all the parameters are handled before you actually dispense that medication. What is a specialty pharmacy? We talked a little bit about this, but it's worth talking about again. It's a service that's been created to manage the handling and service requirements of specialty pharmaceuticals, including the dispensing of the product, the distribution of the product, the reimbursement of the product. These are typically very expensive medications. The average is probably around $2,000 per month, give or take. Many of them go into six figures per year per patient. Case management is very big in this area, and handling that patient from the beginning through the clinical phase. So that means not only are you managing them clinically within the specialty pharmacy, but you're also managing them from a reimbursement point of view. Can they even afford their medication? You're looking for reimbursement support. It's a core function of specialty. It's something that's done under the direction of usually a supervisory pharmacist running that particular area. Disease-specific patient education. We can't stress enough, high touch. The focus is not really on filling prescriptions, but it's on managing a patient. If you go to, and in my career, because I've had a long career at this point, that's why I'm all gray, is that if you're in a mail order pharmacy, for example, it's a lot of throughput in a traditional mail order pharmacy. It's a lot of volume in, a lot of volume out. That's one end of the spectrum. Even when you're in a retail pharmacy, and I'm sure many of you have had the experience, where you go into a pharmacy and you're working, and there is a lot of throughput. I mean, there's a lot of prescriptions coming in, coming out. When you get into specialty, it's less about that volume and more about the management of that patient. There's quite a focus and quite a touch on particular patients. Manufacturers strategically choose a specialty pharmacy with distinctive capabilities required to serve patients, providers, and payers. What's happened in the evolution of specialty pharmacies is that these pharmacies, as they've developed, the pharmacies have developed particular focus in particular disease states and become very, very good at those. And by doing that, have become a go-to pharmacy for manufacturers, especially in limited distribution type of networks. So when a manufacturer is thinking about a limited network for a particular product, the things they're looking at are, you know, what's the payer reach for a particular specialty pharmacy? How many payers are they involved with? The other thing they're looking at is, what is your proficiency in a particular disease state? Are you adept and skilled at working with orphan and ultra-orphan products? Are you adept and skilled at working with oncology or rheumatology products? These things come into play. And what happens is, and I work a lot with the manufacturer, it's really my primary role. And what happens is you create a partnership with a manufacturer, as opposed to it just being a vendor-buyer type, you know, vendor-seller, vendor-buyer type relationship. It's really becoming a partnership with that. And the deeper you get in the spectrum, where you go from the more open products into the limited products, into the exclusive products, when you're in the exclusive, that's almost a day-to-day relationship with the manufacturer. It's very different than what you see in quote-unquote traditional pharmacy. It's a different dynamic that's happening. The other piece that I wanted to mention on here is the robust capability for data reporting and analytics, including adverse events and side effects. So data reporting is very key and very integral to a specialty pharmacy. You oftentimes have to report this data to the payer, to the manufacturer. Ultimately, the manufacturer, if it's a REMS program, has to report it to the government. So you have to be very good at it. And pharmacies are measured by the manufacturers when they're part of these networks. They're measured by the manufacturer in their ability to, A, deliver the data, how accurate the data is, and how timely the data is. And those are hallmarks of being a true specialty pharmacy. Types of specialty pharmacies. So there are the payer-owned PBM-owned specialty pharmacies, which you see up on the screen. The large ones are up top there. They include Accredo, CVS, Prime. Again, you can see examples of retail chain specialty pharmacies, such as Walgreens, Walmart, et cetera. Independent specialty pharmacies like Diplomat, Avella. Health insurer with a PBM or a health plan-owned specialty pharmacy like Optum, RX being one of the largest. Myself and Royce are actually associated with Cardinal Health Specialty Pharmacy, which is a wholesaler-owned specialty pharmacy. There are physician practice type of specialty pharmacies, as well as hospital system and group purchase organization specialty pharmacies, such as Fairview, Comcare, et cetera, That last one, the hospital system one, is a growing area. More and more health systems are actually coming to us for advice on how to begin specialty pharmacies, or should they partner with specialty pharmacies. Health systems have different thoughts around that. Some will partner, and other ones want to build themselves, and some want a hybrid. So you're going to get every gamut of it, and you have to be prepared to work with the systems on the different areas that they choose to do. So again, as you can tell, there are a lot of different ways to work within specialty pharmacies, and there's a lot of opportunities and a lot of different segments of the industry, everything from independent to wholesaler, hospital systems, et cetera. So a very growing area, and it continues to define itself as time goes on and continues to evolve as time goes on. Who are the key stakeholders in specialty? You have the patient. Ultimately, it's the patient. You need to service a patient. Typically, this is a very sick patient. You're talking about oncologic patients. You're usually talking about advanced rheumatology patients. There are significant quality of life issues associated with these patients. So ultimately, you need to service a patient that probably not only has that particular disease, but also has a number of other concomitant diseases that you need to at least be aware of and be able to manage with the one that you're managing at the specialty pharmacy. So it's very important to have a holistic view of the patient as you're dealing with them. You have the physician. You want to try and lower your administrative burden. So what we mean by that is that, especially, for example, I'll take as an example, a limited distribution network. So for example, if a patient has a multiple myeloma as described and is prescribed a product like Revlimid, for example, from Celgene, the pharmacy is truly acting as an extension of that doctor's office. The doctor is not dispensing that product. The pharmacy is, but the pharmacy has to stay in close contact with the doctor because there are multiple side effects that can happen. And if you don't have that close communication, you could have a bad event for that particular patient. So you have to stay close, and you do become a partner, as I mentioned earlier, not only to the manufacturer, but to the physician in that particular area. The payer, again, is another. I mentioned it earlier. As a manufacturer is looking for their partners from a specialty pharmacy point of view, they're looking for your experience and your adeptness at working with particular payers. So the payer is very important. Ultimately, they are paying the bill, and these are very expensive medications. So they want to see that you are able to actually manage the patient, that you're managing them effectively, and that you're basically creating the best possible outcome for that particular payer. Specialty pharmacy, just by its nature, is a lower patient population, but these are very high-spend patients, typically. So again, the payer very interested in the specialty pharmacies that they pick. And we've already spoken about the manufacturer. What are they looking for? They're looking for reliable, seamless distribution, appropriate utilization, patient persistency and adherence. One of the core tenets of specialty pharmacy is clinical management. Within clinical management, you have adherence. So you're trying to keep the patient adherent to the therapy. That is not just from a clinical point of view, but again, as I mentioned earlier, the beginning of that, the reimbursement aspects are important as well. We've heard many times of patients coming off therapy because they simply can't afford to be on the therapy. Within specialty pharmacy, one of our core functions is to make sure that we can make that therapy affordable to a patient and try and find them support in any way we can. There are manufacturer programs that we can work with. There are disease foundations that we can work with. These are all parts of what we try and do within specialty pharmacy. So a little bit about Cardinal Health Specialty Pharmacy, where we work, where myself and Royce work, is we are a URAC-accredited ACHC specialty pharmacy. Accreditation is very important. It is really the only standard in which to measure a true specialty pharmacy at this point in time. The accreditation process is lengthy, it's difficult, and it costs a whole lot of money, but it's the way that you need to do it in order to truly be a specialty pharmacy. Within our specialty pharmacy, there are 50 employees. The pharmacy is actually based not far from here. It's in Columbia, Maryland, so really about 35, 40 minutes from here. We have 13 pharmacists, as you can see how many technicians. We do have access to a number of exclusive and LDD product arrangements and dispense more than 350 specialty products and licensed across the United States and territories. Now, within CHSP and really any specialty pharmacy, these are the important aspects that we do. These are just overviews. Reimbursement services that include benefit verification, coordination of benefits, PA requirements, et cetera. Clinical outreach and support, ensuring coordination of care, patient engagement, we've already talked about that. Financial assistance support, very, very, very important. Medication adherence, we've spoken about that a little bit and how important that is. Site of care coordination. Oftentimes, we're not only dispensing oral meds, we're also dispensing infused medications. So they will need to go somewhere for the infusion, whether it be a home infusion with nurse support, whether it be at a clinic, at an outpatient facility of some sort, we need to coordinate that care so that the patient and the product show up at the same time so that they're ready for the infusion. That's part of what specialty pharmacy does as well. It's 24-hour support. We already talked about the REMS programs and the data reporting. a little bit. So really, these are key tenets. These are core offerings within really any specialty pharmacy. As we go forward now into the next presentation after the break, we're going to take a deeper dive into some of these, and Royce is really going to talk about the journey of a patient, kind of a day in the life of a patient as they go through a specialty pharmacy.